Guys, welcome to my YouTube channel Chem5. Today we are going to discuss about very interesting and also very important aspect of chemistry, that is qualitative analysis of inorganic salts. Qualitative analysis of inorganic salts and mixture is an essential experiment carried out in plus 2 level in schools, undergraduate and postgraduate level. So today we are going to discuss about the group separation. And group separation is a process to identify the cations present in the solution. At first, let us know why group separation is so important. It is a very common experiment in analytical chemistry. If we think about an environmental chemist, suppose he has soil or water sample and he wants to know if lead, mercury or any other heavy metal or toxic ion are present in the sample or not, then he follows the process of the group separation. So what is the group separation? Here we divide most of all cations in 5 groups and experimentally found some specific reagents which can form precipitations of ions from one group only. Cationic analysis depends on the solubility product of the ion. If the solubility product is greater than the ionic product, the solution is unsaturated and no precipitation will form. And if the solubility product is lower than the ionic product, we can see the precipitate. So here we should strictly maintain the sequence of the group while performing the experiment. So here are the groups. Here are the 5 groups. So you can see that the mercury, lead and silver form insoluble chlorides, and they in the group 1. Group 2 contains arsenic, bismuth and other ions. They form insoluble sulfides in acidic media. Group 3 contains cobalt, ferrous and ferric and others ion, and they form insoluble sulfides and hydroxides in basic media. Group 4 contains magnesium, calcium, strontium and barium plus 2, and they form mostly insoluble carbonates and phosphates. And group 5 contains mostly alkali metals and ammonium. So let's start the separation of the group 1 molecule. So group 1 ion, that is silver plus, lead plus 2 and Hg2 plus 2, form the insoluble chlorides. And that is why the hydrochloric acid is used as the group reagent. We generally use 6 molar HCl, because if we use more concentrated HCl, then Pb plus 2 ion may form a complex ion, that PbCl4 minus 2, which is soluble in aqueous solution. And if it forms, then we cannot get the white precipitate of lead chloride. All the precipitate, that the AgCl, PbCl2 and Hg2Cl2 precipitation are of white color, and we cannot distinguish them from their color. So we have to do separate confirmatory test from each of the ion. So let us solution of ions. We add 6 molar HCl in the solution and centrifuge it. We will found a white precipitate of either AgCl or Pb plus 2 or Hg plus 2 or more than one of them. And the rest of the solution will contain the ions of other groups, or maybe our group 2 to group 5. So now in white precipitate, we add hot water and centrifuge it. PbCl2 is quite soluble in the hot water, and if PbCl2 is present in the white precipitation, it will dissolve in the hot water. So after centrifugation, we will find a white precipitate of AgCl or Hg2Cl2, and the solution of hot water will contain the Pb plus 2. So if we add chromate ion in the solution, we will find yellowish precipitate of lead chromate, and it is the confirmatory test of Pb plus 2. And here is the reaction of it, that Pb plus 2 plus K2CrO4 will form lead chromate plus 2 potassium ions. So if Pb plus 2 is present in the main solution, then we find the yellowish precipitate, otherwise we will not find it. So here in white precipitate, we are going to add 6 molar ammonia solution, and if AgCl is present in the white precipitate, it will dissolve in the 6 molar ammonia solution. And if Hg2Cl2 present it in it, then it will form a gray precipitate. So here is the reaction, how the gray precipitate will form, that Hg2Cl2 aqueous will react with ammonia and form black Hg or black mercury and white HgNH2Cl solid, and their mixture will form a gray precipitate. So by the centrifugation, we can get the solution which contain the Ag plus ion. And if we add 6 molar nitric acid in it, we will find white precipitate, and it confirms the presence of Ag plus. If Ag plus is not present in the solution, we will not find any white precipitate after adding 6 molar HNO3. So if we find it, here is the reaction, that AgNH3O2 plus, and it is the complex ion which form AgCl soluble in ammonia. So it will react with acid and all ammonia will convert it in the NH4+, and Ag+ will again form a white precipitate with Cl-, that is AgCl, and thus we can separate all the ions of the group 1. Thank you for watching the video. If you enjoyed it, please like it, share it and subscribe my channel. Thank you.